Welcome to online biology class and myself Lavanya and today's topic is continuation on fundamental unit of life. In the last session we already discussed about the cell, how the cell is going to be formed and what are the components are present in the cell and how we are going to be define the cell from the onion cell. Yes, and also we discussed about the study of microscope and how many types of microscopes are there we discussed, and the basic parts present in the microscopes also we discussed, and how we are going to be see the cells from the help of the onion. Also we did one activity. That activity we are going to be known that the cells are compactly packed each other. If one component, now I will take one example of different types of cells are having different structures. Now take example of living organisms. There are plants is there, animals are there, and next microorganisms also are there. Yes, plant cell structure is like this. Animal cell structures are many shapes and different sizes. Yes, and microorganisms also same, they are having many shapes and different sizes. Now I am going to be take the examples of some unicellular organisms. Unicellular organisms. Unicellular organisms examples are amoeba, plasmodium, etc. and multicellular organisms. Example, plant cell, animal cell. Yes or no? Yes. Unicellular means only single cell will be present. Single cell. But multicellular means many cells are present. That's why the microorganisms, they can be divided very fastly. That the amoeba, plasmodium, bivalves, these organisms, they are not having any shape. Amoeba is not having shape. Shapeless. These amoeba, it can be changed. If the food will be available near the amoeba can change the shape. And if the any new organism near came to the amoeba can change the shape. Like that, the amoeba can be change its shape. And next, plasmodium bivalves. It is a parasite. It may cause the malaria disease. Okay, na? Malaria fever. Become the malaria fever. And next, multicellular organisms. Multicellular organisms means the cell is, yesterday we discussed, this is one cell. This is one cell. Again, two, three, four. How they are joined? They are joined each other and it form as a structure. That's why we named it as a honeycomb structure. Like that, a particular cell. Now I am going to be take the examples in multicellular organism. Now I am taking the example of in human beings, brain cells. Brain cell structure, how it will be? This is the structure of nerve cells. Like the different structures are there in multicellular. All the nerves will be in this structure only, and all the blood cells will be in a round structure. There are based on the shape, different names are there for the cells. Yes, in multicellular examples are plant cell and animal cell. Now I am telling that there are the structures are there. The structures are different from each organism. Plant structures are different, and animal structure cells are different, and human being structure cells are different. But the basic nerve cell, bone cell, ova cells, sperm cells, these all the same only. They all are compact, combined with each other, and they are going to perform a function. Now the nerve cells, I told you. Nerve cells function, what does the nerve cell function? It can transmit the information from one nerve cell to another nerve cell. Then the nerve cell is doing that function. That's right. Like that, the bone cells present in the bone marrow, they will do that function. What that they will do? They need to be collect the blood, and it need to be produce the hemoglobin. That is the bone cell function. And next, the ova function. What is the ova function? At the time to time, the ova needs to be released. That the function ova will do. And next, heart cells. What does the heart cells will do? The heart cells will collect the blood and pump it to each and every organ present in our body. That is the heart cell function. Like that, in multicellular organisms, every specific cell is having specific function. No one needs to tell to them. They know their function and they will be do that. Like amoeba, if any food particle came near to amoeba, the amoeba will be take the food, engulf it. It will engulf the food molecules. At that time, amoeba can change the shape. But multicellular organisms cannot change the shape. Yes, again you may have some doubt. Ma'am, the cells cannot change. How does we know that the part present in our body is going to be get damaged? At that time, what does the doctors do? They will take the sample of if your liver is going to be excrete some fluid in your body, it may be known with the help of blood test, or else they will take some small samples of the with the help of biopsy, with the needle, they will collect some cells near the liver and they are going to be examined. At that time, the liver cells exact space, exact shape is different than your liver cells. At that time, they may know that your liver is going to be get spoiled or your liver is having some infection by the blood or biopsy. They may know. Like that, every organism, multicellular organism, they are having specific shape and specific function they needs to be do. Yes. Next. Now we will see some structures of your human body cells. Yes. Muscle cell. Thank you. nerve cell, blood cell, sperm cell, fat cell. You are having fat in your body, no? Like that, the fat cells also will be present. Like here, the nerve cell, muscle cell, nerve cell shape is same. No, they are having different shape and they know that which function they wants to do. Now you should see the muscle cell, what does it do? It will be do that contraction and relaxation of muscles. Yes, no? When you are walking, when you are doing exercises, your muscle cells will do the more function. Why? It will be contract and relaxation of your muscles. The muscle cell will do that function. And if the nerve cells, what does it do? Transfer the information by with the help of these tendrils. It can be joined with another nerve cell. Okay, that's why it will be passes to from here to the next nerve cell. Okay, this is the one and two and three. Like that, it will be passes. It will be passes to one nerve to another nerve cell. And next, blood cells. The blood cells function, what does it do? It needs to be collect the hemoglobin and function it and functions for energy. Functions for giving energy. To whom the energy is giving? The energy needs to be given for it, us. Okay? And next, ova. Ova, what does it do? Needs to be mature at the right time. Okay? And next, sperm cell, what does it do? These also say mature at time. Okay? And next, fat cell. Fat cell, what does it do? The fat cell will be do that storage the fat and release and convert the fat cells to energy. When it will be converted, the fat cells, when it is going to be converted into energy cells, when you are having fasting time, when you didn't had any breakfast at the correct time, at the time also you may are having some energy. How you are having that energy without eating food? The fat cells present in your body, it is going to be get burned and giving you energy to stable and to do the work, continuity of your work in your body. At that time the fat cells will do the function. Like this, in multicellular organisms, different cells are having different shapes and different functions. But in unicellular organisms, this facility is not there. In unicellular organisms, some common organelles are there. Both in unicellular and multicellular. What are they? Plasma membrane, nucleus, cytoplasm. Plasma membrane, nucleus, cytoplasm. These three cell organelles are common in both unicellular and multicellular. But in multicellular, other different organelles also will be there. But again, it will be different from plant cell and animal cell. That you will see. I am going to be tell you that what are the cell organelles present in a cell. That's why the functions will be different, but all will be clubbed. All the muscle cells will be joined like this. They all will be compact each other, and they are doing the basic function. These all the organisms present and formed as an organism. That is the human being or any amoeba or any chlamydomonas or any plasma membrane or any plant. But the basic, the unit of life is cell. The cell may contain all the cell organelles. The cell organelles nothing but the cell components. And in next you will see that cell organelles. Yes, first one is cell wall. Second one is plasma membrane. Third one is cytoplasm. And the fourth one is nucleus. Fifth one is nuclear membrane. And the sixth one is endoplasmic reticulum. And the seventh one is vacuoles. And the eighth one is mitochondria. And the ninth one is chloroplast. And the tenth one is Golgi complex. And the 11th one is lysosomes. And the 12th one is ribosomes, etc. Still some more are there. It will be, I will talk to you in the next class. Okay, first listen here. Cell wall, plasma membrane, cytoplasm, nucleus, nuclear membrane, endoplasmic reticulum, lysosomes, ribosomes, and the mitochondria and the Golgi complex, lysosomes, they are having different functions. These and all will be present in one cell only. In one cell, whether it is a plant cell or animal cell, they all will be present in single cell. If the fat cell wants to do that, the fat cell all will be clubbed like this. Yes or not? In these particular cell is containing all these cell organelles. In these cell organelles also specific function is there. Like mitochondria will be helpful for ATP production. ATP is nothing but energy, adenosine triphosphate. Like that, the cytoplasm will be helpful to hold these and all cell organelles in a correct position, and the nucleus is having and the vacuoles are helpful for storage food. Storage food. And the ribosomes are going to be helpful to produce the proteins. Like that, different cell organelles are also having different function and they are having their specific shape also. Like that, in human being or else in any living organisms are having the cells. The cells are specific function and specific shape and specific size is there to perform the activity. Yes, today's session is going to be completed, children. And tomorrow I am going to be teach you about the plasma membrane. Yes, we will be enter into the cell organelles one by one in the next sessions. I think today in this session you discussed about the different types of structures are there and their function we discussed, and unicellular, multicellular we discussed, and tomorrow session we are going to be see the cell organelles. Thank you, children.